All right, I'm Bob Baylor, and I work at Cincinnati State, dealing with college students. What is it a college student really wants to know? It's not the material the professor has to teach. They want to know, how do I pass your class? Well, you come to your class, read a textbook, read your notes. But you know what the typical student says? It can't be that simple. I got to come to class, read the textbook, and actually study the notes. Yeah, it's that simple. So why can't it be that simple? And I started to think about, well, what's your life look like? Well, I think most college students' life looks something like this. They have a lot of distractions going on in their life. They have family obligations, social obligations, Facebook obligations, and it's keeping them from experiencing life in a simple way. And if that isn't enough to distract them, this is where the colleges get into it. And we make the application process, the financial aid process, or scheduling an appointment with your academic advisor look something like this. So the world to them cannot be very simple, and if they can't experience the world in a simple way, how is it that they're going to be able to understand what Da Vinci was getting at when he said simplicity is the ultimate sophistication? Why is this an important quote? Well, because in the college business, that's what we're supposed to be doing, is creating sophisticated minds, right? So how am I going to create a sophisticated mind in the 21st century? Well, unfortunately, this is what a sophisticated mind is. Multitasking, which means that you're doing a bunch of different things half-assed, right? And why do you do things half-assed when you're multitasking? Well, some of the other speakers have already brought up, because our brain only functions optimally working with about four or five things. You give it too many things, and guess what? The brain doesn't like it anymore. And the brain is very good at self-defense. When you give it too much stuff to do, the brain says, I'm overloaded, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to make you bored. And we stupidly go with being bored, and we think, oh, I need to go out, I need to find something new, something more exciting, instead of concentrating on the simple and arriving at something sophisticated. So maybe that's what Longfellow was getting at here when he said, we ascribe the beauty which is simple, which has no superfluous parts, which exactly answers its end. Kind of sounds like an engineer. Maybe there is some inspiration in that. So I started looking at how engineers used to do business back in the early part of the 20th century, and they used simple tools, slide rule and a stubby pencil. And yet they were able to arrive at sophisticated solutions to problems. Why? Because they weren't distracted. So if you left an engineer alone, they might come up with something like, an aircraft that could fly 3 times the speed of sound at 80,000 feet. Kelly Johnson did this with a stubby pencil and a slide rule. Or give the same simple tools to somebody like Frank Lloyd Wright and stand back and look at what he could do. He could create a waterfall house, a sophisticated solution using very simple tools. Wow, that's great stuff, except those guys lived in the last century and the 20th century. I'm dealing with 21st century college students, and this is something that I get to see every day. Why? Because their lives are complicated. They're bored. I've got to try to get them focused on simplicity, right? I've got to get them to being sophisticated. So first of all, I've got to try and convince them that Marcus Aurelius had a great idea when he said, make thyself all simplicity. Yeah, that's great, Bob. Okay, keep working at it. Okay, so University of Wisconsin gave me a great tool. University of Wisconsin recently found out that handwriting is actually faster than typing. Not only is it faster than typing, but you, when you write, actually create more sophisticated thoughts. Now I got an idea. Now I can give them a sophisticated way and a simple way to start arriving at a sophisticated thought. Okay, give me some proof about this. Well, Mark Twain used to run around everywhere he went with a notebook, and he used to write down all of his experiences and all his witticisms. And he took this everywhere he went, and eventually he was able to do things like write something called Tom Sawyer. So instead of having a mind filled with garbage and distractions, he was able to take all of his thoughts and produce something that was very sophisticated and very elegant. So if we can get our students focusing back on the simple thing of handwriting again, we can take them away from this and take them to this. Give them a very sophisticated way of thinking. Now, why are you all out here caring about that? Because if we have more sophisticated minds out there, then that's going to be a benefit to all of us. Those sophisticated minds are going to be able to stop looking inward, and they're going to start looking outward. And by looking outward, they're going to realize what the problems are going on in the world, and they're going to give us the Kelly Johnson solutions and the Frank Lloyd Wright solutions to what's going on in the world. So, since I'm not that great of a mind, I want to leave you with one final thought, and this comes from Nathaniel Hawthorne. And you can read all this, I just want to focus on the last part. Poverty will not be poverty, nor weakness will not be weakness. The simplicity is in your hands, and that's how you arrive at sophistication. Thank you.